Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Sanyal here. Welcome to our next dissection. This time, I'm going to demonstrate the structures which are crossing the dorsal aspect of the wrist joint through the extensor retinaculum. If you look carefully, you'll see a band of fibers going obliquely from the radial side to the ulnar side. And you can see the fibers here. This is the extensor retinaculum. And my probe, my instrument has gone under that. It is the extensor retinaculum. And you can see it has gone in. It starts from the radial side and it goes all the way, encircles the wrist, and it comes back and it gets attached to the radial bone. And in the process, it divides the dorsal aspect of the wrist into 6 compartments. Let's see what are the structures which go through each of the compartments. By knowing the structures going through, we automatically come to know what are the muscles on the extensor aspect of the arm. So let's start with compartment number 1 on the radial most side. We can see these tendons here. Abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis. That's compartment number 1. Let's jump to compartment number 3. Extensor pollicis longus. Compartment number 2 is the extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis. Compartment number 4. Can we see these tendons here? These are the extensor digitorum tendons. 1, 2, 3, 4. The extensor digitorum tendons and the extensor indices, they go through compartment number 4. Compartment number 5, can we see this tendon here? The extensor digiti minimi. And compartment number 6, we can see a tendon here. This is the extensor carpi ulnaris. So these are the 6 compartments which go under the extensor retinaculum. Now I need to show you a very important anatomical landmark which has also got a clinical significance, and that is this structure here. This is called the anatomical snuffbox. Let's take a look at the boundaries of the anatomical snuffbox. It has got a lateral boundary, which I had mentioned earlier, composed of the abductor pollicis longus and the extensor pollicis brevis. It has got a medial boundary, extensor pollicis longus. The floor of the anatomical snuffbox is composed of 4 bones. Going from proximal to distal, proximally we have the radial styloid process. If I dip my finger, in fact, this is something which you can even feel in your own hand. If I dip my finger in, I feel the scaphoid bone. Then I feel the trapezium. And if I distally, I can feel this bone here. This is the base of the first metacarpal. So this is the depression. Why is this significant? Because passing through the floor of the anatomical snuffbox is this important structure which I have lifted up here. This is the radial artery. Let's trace the radial artery from here. If you remember, this was our radial artery. The radial artery, it comes here. This is where we feel the radial pulse, and then it goes under this tendon. You can see it going under this tendon, and it comes here. So the radial artery crosses the anatomical snuffbox, and we can see it clearly here. This is the radial artery. And after it passes from here, it gives rise to several major branches. It gives a branch to the thumb called the princeps pollicis. Then it gives a branch to the index finger called the radialis indicis. And after that, the same radial artery then pierces the first dorsal intraosseous muscle here. And it comes on the palmar side and it forms a deep palmar arch. So this is the course of the radial artery, and from there it supplies the metacarpal arteries. So this is the anatomical snuffbox, and normally it is covered by fascia, and it is also crossed over by the superficial branch of the radial nerve. So these are the structures which are seen on the dorsal aspect and the anatomical snuffbox. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal signing out.